So this morning, kind of a funky morning. We had a couple good reads, a couple good trades, but then a few trades where I might have just been a little too greedy. And I've got to put myself in check sometimes. I got to remember, like, hey, you know, not every day is going to have big moves. Not every day are we going to get those 10, 20 handle moves. Sometimes we got to take profit. Like, just take profit, Patrick. Stop being an idiot. Stop being an idiot. Take profit. Be happy, walk away with that profit, and that's what we did today. We walked away in the green, and that's all we can do. We got to focus on the plan, focus on taking the money and walking away. So I'm going to show you guys a bunch of live trades here from the live stream this morning. If you haven't already tuned in, 9:15 a.m., you know where to tune in right here live every morning. See you guys tomorrow morning. Watching to see what happens here. A lot of liquidity coming in at the 48s right now. Let's get rid of that liquidity. Push to the 50s next. Looking for a possible long here. Back in it long right now. Looking to see if we can push up. I got stopped out on that last one, but see if we can make that back on this trade here. Get that push up there to the 54s next. Through the 50s now. Just needed a bigger stop there. Can we push all the way through the 50s up there to the 54s? Push up there 51s. Looking for 54 push. Pushing 52s here, beautiful. Can we get more? Give me more, baby. Moving my stop up here to basically break even now. See if we can get this push all the way to the 54s. The NASDAQ trying to squeeze up. The ES trying to squeeze up here. Pushing 52, 53s now. I think 55s is doable here. So that's why my 54 target, 54.24. 54.25, sorry. Through the 53s, looking for 54.25. Getting filled, beautiful, let's go. All right, so we lost 500 on that first trade. We made it back 1300 on that last trade. Nice and easy, baby, nice and easy here. You can see, let's talk about why we thought this would squeeze up there, why we took two long opportunities, thinking this was gonna push up. We had a couple reasons for that. We had a couple reasons just based on kind of overall strategy. We had the MACD cross here pre-market. We had this level, that 49.50 level. That's what we kind of were watching. I was a little early to get in on that. I think that was my big mistake on that first trade. If I would have just been a little bit more patient on that first trade there, you can see like my first entry here, I tried to jump in there at 48.25. It ended up stopping me out. If I probably would just waited for, you know, a little bit more time, kind of saw that chop on the book map, but if I'd have been a little bit more patient, I think I would have been okay. But hey, we ended up making it back there. You know, the focus always is very simple. You know, if you look here, we made $1,300 on that one trade. We lost $550 on that first trade. So keeping our losers smaller than our winners, obviously. And that's the big focus here. So we'll continue on with that momentum here and see if we can't get another big move. Right now, Top Step is offering a 30% discount. You can sign up for the Combine this week. There's a link down below. You guys want to learn more? You want to get into trading futures? There's never been a better time, never been a cheaper time to do it with Top Step right now with a 30% discount. Link down below. Check them out. The MACD trying to push up here. Momentum to the downside slowing down now. Get this push back to the 40s. Just kind of a hard spot because we're just kind of looking bearish, but it seems like the market just doesn't want to go down here. So we got to kind of break out of this downward trend here and show some strength and get up there into the 40s to show the bulls are in control here. Looking for this reversal off the bottom. I'm tired of sitting down there getting chopped up. So let's just hold it and look for this move up there to the 40s again. Give me that 40 push here. 40 push. I'll take 39.50s. Maybe a little bit more. Let me move one target up into the 40s. One at 39s here. Beautiful. Let me just go 40s and higher. Through the 39s now. Beautiful. Looking for 41s. Let me go a little bit higher on this actually. 42s for my first target. That'll be $1,700 on that one trade alone. $1,700. Let's go. Through the 40s now, got that reversal off the bottom. We're looking for a nice little squeeze up. Give me $2,000, baby, $2,000. Make you a holla. Ooh, up there to the 40, 50, pulling back now. Oh gosh. We're right there at that pivot point on the SPY here. So running into that pivot now. I'm just going to kind of hold this one. I think there's momentum here. Can try to push up and get above that pivot. The VWAP on the ES is 48. I don't love this pullback here, I'll tell you that. Fuck me. Oh, I'm going to just put my break even. I don't want to let this turn red on me at least. And I'm going to try to jump back in long here, I guess. This thing doesn't want to drop. I'm going to go long with it. I think we want to touch that VWAP again here on the ES. We'll see. Might be some choppy action to get there, but something's telling me we're going to touch VWAP again here. Maybe not right now, but in today at some point. The rooster's crowing. Come on, give me the rooster crow. Boner candle to the upside here through the 40s. Market having some trouble here. Again, there's some support forming at the 36s. That liquidity sitting down there on the book map right now. Will they hold it up here? Try to squeeze it higher. Need more volume to come in. We got the MACD cross. We got the pivot on the SPY here. So a couple things going against us right now with that pivot there acting as resistance at the 403.31 area on the SPY. Got two contracts left here, trying to get this pushed above the 40s, but having some trouble. Might get stopped out at the 34s again. If you guys haven't already hit that like button, blow up that like button. We got 547 likes. Can we get 600 likes on the stream here? Squeeze it back up there, 38s again. This thing looking like she wants to break. Look at the 3-minute chart. This thing break above that 38 level again. Push up here into the 44, 45 level. Let's see. We got the momentum on our side right now. Can we squeeze? Got to get through that. The problem right now, like I said, is that pivot point. We're right there at that pivot on the SPY here. If we get through that pivot, we go, go, go. There we go. 39s now. Can we go all the way to the 40s on the book map right now? Showing that liquidity there at the 40s. After that, 45 level up there is what I'm looking for. Got some liquidity set in the 42s, but that 45 level just looks like it wants to get touched here. Can she do it? Trying to get through 38s. Having some trouble there right now. Just watching to see. I'm going to move my stop up here to the 35s now. Guarantee 275 profit there. Or actually, we'll move it 300 guaranteed. We can't lose. We're guaranteed at least $300 in profit, but we want to get more, baby. Eric Daniels said that he got the book map yesterday and thinks that it was a great decision. Hey, great to hear. Happy to hear, my friend. Trying to push through the 40s again. Just getting stuck right there at the 39. There we go. Whoa, she's ramping up. She's ramping. We're trying to go for that 44s. This is what I was looking for earlier. I was looking for this move through the 40s earlier. We got stopped out for break even. But right now, looking for this to push through 42s up there to the 44s next. Can we get through it? On the book map, there's a bunch of liquidity sitting there. 41s, 42s. Can she push all the way through there? That liquidity taken out right now. There's gone at the 41s. We got 42 liquidity next and then 44, 45 level. So I'm looking for 44s here as my target. There we go. Through the 42s now. Beautiful. We're up almost $1,000 on just two contracts here. Looking for 44.50 being my target here. Can we go all the way? 44.50. Come on, baby. The book map showing liquidity at the 42s again. We push 42s. Looking for that push to the 44s. We got through that pivot on the SPY now. Can we push all the way? Pulling back here to the 40s now. Still looking for that push up there to the 44s. Trying to push here. See what's next candle opens up. This is a 2000 tick chart we're looking at right now. 2000 tick chart. A lot of liquidity just came in here on the book map. It's trying to push through the 42s. The battle is real on the book map right now. You see all that liquidity just was below us for a second. Then it squeezed back up there above 42s now. So trying to get this push up there. 44s. Can it happen? 43s coming up. We're looking for 44s. Come on, give me that $1,000. It'll be like $1,200 on this two contracts here. Through the 43s next. We're rocking, we're rolling, baby. Got my target at the 44.50s. Trying to eat it. Trying to eat away that liquidity here on the book map right now. Looking heavy, actually, on the book map, but we just keep volume up. Keep pushing. They're sitting there, 42s, trying to hold it down heavy. The shorts. The bears, the bulls. The battle is real. We're back above the pivot now on the SPY. We're back above the pivot there at the 403.40 levels. So let's see what happens here, how this plays out. Maybe a little pullback here. Turn that 40 area into support and then try to squeeze up there 44s. Looking like she wants to go here though. 41s again, 42s. Give me that 44 push, baby. Looking good. Come on, let's get it right here. Oh, it looked good for a second. It looked good for 1 second on the book map here. It was looking like I wanted to squeeze through, then that liquidity came in there again. They're playing games with it. They're playing games with it. 38's my stop here. Looks like we might get stopped out. Oh, 39's just stepped up there. Oh gosh. The battle is real. They're holding that pivot now, trying to hold that pivot on the SPY. That last candle was literally a doji right there on that pivot point. And about to get stopped out here. Stopped out for $600 in profit. And we're just going sideways. Fuck. Is what it is. We're still green on the day. I'm not mad about it, but still. Obviously, we want a bigger move to happen here. There we go. Down to the 30s. Beautiful. Let's see if we get this all the way down to the 29s. Finally, give me a fucking fill down here, the 29s. Watch, it's going to bounce down. I hate my life. I fucking hate it. I got to stop. I got to stop doing this stupid shit. I got to stop it. I got to stop looking at the chart. I got to just stop it all. Looking for this move down below the 30s, down to the 29s. Just fucking give it to me already. Then I can walk away and be done. Go buy my surfboard. Just give me it. Just do it. Oh, God. I'm just going to take it. I'm going to take $900. I'm done. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to sit there and try to get another fucking $20.